Yes, good morning friends, how are you all? Fine, very good. Welcome back to online classes again. So we know that already I started revision and we are in revision only. Today I am going to deal with the topic circles. Okay, so this is a geometrical part, right? It comes under mensuration. Okay, sorry, it comes under geometry. We know that in geometry we will have triangles. Next, triangles, circles and construction. These three will comes under geometry portion. Okay, so in geometry you know how many marks? 15 marks are there. Okay, triangles, circles and constructions, you will have 15 marks. In that circles, very simple chapter, but we should know the sum of the concepts. First of all, how you will form a circle? How will you form a circle? When you fix the points or fix the one end of the row and second row you just rotate, you will form like this. So this is known as a circle. Okay na? So circle means, so what is the definition of exact circle, you know? It is very simple. Line joining of the points which are equidistant from a fixed point. Which are equidistant from a fixed point. This fixed point is known as center. Fixed point is known as center. So the line joining of the center to any point on the radius, on the circle, it is nothing but radius. It is radius. The line joining of any two points on the circle, it is known as chord. It is known as chord. And the part of a circle is known as arc. It is known as arc. Therefore, the space occupied by the chord and arc is nothing but a segment. What is that? Segment. If you are drawing the circle chords like this, but some chords will pass through the center, this chord is known as diameter. Okay na? Always diameter is equals to 2 times of radius, or half of diameter is nothing but radius. Either this is that, either this also that. Now, if two radii are there like this, then the space occupied by two radii and arc is nothing but yes, sector. What is that? Sector. Yes. Some of these definitions you should know, because this will help in the next chapter, that is areas related to circle. Okay, there we come across chord, segment, sector, major segment, minor segment, radius and diameter. Yes, like that. So these are all comes under your this also. What is that? Surface areas and volumes also. Okay na? Right. Yes, in this we are very much interested, not only these definitions, we are very much interested in the new definitions that we don't know, now we discuss. Okay na? For example, if you take a circle, yes, if you take the lines three different lines, okay na? Three different lines, AB, CD, EF, XY. Now, this AB is not at all intersecting with the circle. circle, therefore there is no problem at all. We are not interested in AB. Okay, na? Next, we are not interested means over. We are never interested. This CD is intersecting the point at P. Therefore, this CD is known as tangent. What is this? Tangent. It is very, very important. Therefore, this CD is known as what? Tangent. When this EF is intersecting the circle at two different points inside, that is one at X and one is at, this is known as secant. What is this? Secant. But here also, we are not interested in this. But we are interested only in this tangents. Okay, na? So today we are going to discuss about the only tangents. How the tangents, what are the properties of tangents like that. Okay, na? Right. Very, very simple. Now, it is a circle. It is a tangent. AB is a tangent. This is O and this is P. This AB is a straight line which is touching the circle at P. Now we have to find out the result of this. Result of this. Very, very simple. What I am doing is, if you take OP for example, if P is like this, one more distance is like this, Q. Is it OQ is greater than OP only? Again you take one more, is Q1 and Q2. Again OQ2 is greater than OP only. Again you take one more, again you take one more, again you take, again you take. All these are all greater than OP only. So that means what? OP is the shortest distance. Shortest distance. This is possible only if OP is perpendicular to AB. Okay, na? This is possible. Which side, whichever side you want, you can take. Like this, like this, like this, like this. Yes, yes. Okay, na? But except this. So, this is the short distance. Therefore, when it is short means 100% it will be perpendicular. Therefore, by this, what we come to know? The tangent drawn to a point is perpendicular to the radius. Okay, na? So this is the radius or not? This is the radius. These are all not radius, only this is only radius. This line is only OP, only radius. Remaining all not radius. Right? Understood? Therefore, always OP will be perpendicular to the drawn tangent. This is a very, very important result. Okay? So, result what? Always the radius will be perpendicular to the tangent, or tangent drawn will be perpendicular to the radius of the given circle. Okay? Na? Right. So, this is very, very, very important. Okay. Now, one more. If you take a circle . This is a tangent x y o p. One more line I am taking, point is Q. This line is passing through the center. We have to put this line is
passing through the center.
Very very simple. Since we know that always radius will be perpendicular to the tangent, therefore it is equal to 90. It is also 90. This is 90 means this also 90. This also 90. If linear plane is 180, then what happened? OQ is a straight line. The OQ is straight line is what? It is passing through the point only P. That is what? OQ is a straight line, yes, passing through the center. Passing through the center. Understood now? Very very simple. This is 90, but of sum of these two angles is also 180, sum of these two angles also, therefore OQ is a straight line. Right? Okay. Next. One more important theorem. The theorem is like this. These are the radii of the circle and these are the tangents drawn from the outside, that is A, B, P. We have to prove that the tangents drawn from the external are equal. That means what? We have to prove that AP equal to BP. Very very simple. Now we know that the radius of the circle is perpendicular to the tangent, therefore 90 degrees. This is also 90 degrees. Okay. Now consider these two triangles. Now you can write, consider the triangles. Which triangles? AOP and BOP. AP, sorry, angle OAP is equals to angle OBP equal to 90 degrees, because the radius will be perpendicular to the tangent. Next, OP equal to OP. Okay, common side. Next, OA equal to OB because radii. Understood? Now over. Therefore, triangle OAP is congruent to triangle OBP by RHS condition. When the RHS condition, these two are congruent, means automatically what happened? AP will be equal to BP by CPCT. CPCT means corresponding parts of corresponding triangles. Sorry, corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Okay, na? So very very simple. So we have proved that the tangents drawn from the external points are equal. The tangents drawn from the external point are equal. What are the equal? AP equal to BP. This is fixed for all the tangents. Okay, na? So this is considered as a theorem, and they may ask for 3 marks question or sometimes 4 marks question also. Okay, na? This is very very important. Now one more important theorem is there. Yes. What is that theorem? You see. Yes. This xy is a diameter and PQ and RS are the two tangents. So we should prove that PQ is parallel to RS. Right. Now OY is a radius, therefore, and RS is a tangent, the angle between them is 90 degrees, and here also 90 degrees and 90 degrees. If you see, interior alternate angles are equal, therefore, these two, when interior alternate angles are equal, when these two lines will be parallel. Correct or not? Therefore, PQ is parallel to RS. You can prove like this. How to prove? Very simple. Angle RYO is equals to angle SYO, because why? Yes, radius is perpendicular to the tangent. Next one. Second one, PXO is equals to QXO, because same, but RYO is equals to QXY and PXO is equals to SYO is equals to 90 degrees. Therefore, PQ is parallel to RS, because why? The interior alternate angles are equal. Okay, no? Interior alternate angles are equal. Understood? Like this. Now we will see the problems. Most commonly, when 5 or 6 problems are there, they are going to ask one or the other. Okay, no? We will discuss them. In that, one problem is like this. If this is a circle, AB coordinate like this, ABCD, PQRS, then we have to do that AB plus BC is equals to AD plus BC. Okay, now we'll prove the problem. First thing you draw, yes, first thing see, AB and AS, what are they? Yes, tangents. Write down like that. AS equal to AB. Second, DS equal to DR. Next, BP is equals to BQ. Next, CR equal to CQ. Now you add however you want. I will add like this: AP plus BP. AP plus BP. Next, DR plus CR. Now AP is equals to what? AS. BP is equals to what? BQ. DR is equals to what? DS. CR is equals to what? CQ. Now AP plus BP, AP plus BP, what is that? These two one bracket, these two one bracket. Therefore you can write AB plus BC. In this again AS plus BS one bracket and BQ plus CQ one more bracket. So already AB plus BC is equals to AD plus BC. Okay, na? So this is 2 marks question. How many marks? 2 marks. Very very important question. AP plus BP plus BR plus CR equal to AS plus BQ plus DS plus CQ. So AB plus BC equal to AS plus DS like this. Okay, na? Very simple problem, right? After proving this only, on this only one application is there. Okay, right? What is that application we see? Yes, this is a circle. If parallelogram is inscribing, if ABCD is a parallelogram, then PQRS. If ABCD is a parallelogram, then prove that ABCD is a rhombus. So very very simple. Before only we have seen that. What we have seen? AB plus BC is equals to AD plus BC. We know that. Okay, na? Just now only we know. But here in parallelogram means opposite sides are equal. Opposite sides are equal. Therefore, what I can write? AB plus BC is also I can write AB, and AD plus BC is also I will write AD, because you can write here. Yes, in parallelogram opposite sides are equal. Opposite sides are equal. Therefore, AB plus AB, 2AB is equals to 2AD. 2 to cancel. Therefore, what happened? AB equal to AD. But AB equal to AD and AB equal to DC and AD equal to BC, which implies DC also equal to BC. Therefore, AB equal to BC equal to CD equal to AD. Therefore, ABCD is a rhombus. Yes, one more very important problem. This problem they asked many times for 3 marks question or for 5 marks question. Okay, na? So very very simple. But at the same time, you should know the concepts also, right? No problem. Yes. XY and X dash Y dash both are parallel. PQ is a diameter. Here one more. Here O is the center. Join. Yes. AB is one more tangent. AB is the tangent which is intersecting XY at A and X dash Y dash at B. Now we have to prove that angle AOB equal to 90 degrees. Angle AOB equal to 90 degrees. Very very simple. Okay na? So for that I will do like this. Just I am taking like this. See. Now you see what is the relationship between AP and AC. Anyone? AP and AC. So before that we have proved one theorem. What is the theorem? Theorem was like this. Yes. 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 See, it is like this only or not? AP and AC. Here you see A, B, here B and correct? There we have proved that these two sides are same and these two angles are same and these two angles are also same. Now implement in this. Then what happened? This angle equal to this angle and this angle equal to this angle. Okay na? Now instead of PAC, because angle same or not? Here also same. Angle PAC, not same. PAC plus QBC. Sorry, QBC. These two lines are parallel. This will be a AB is a transversal. Therefore, angle A plus angle B is equals to 180 degrees. Why? If a like this. Again theorem. If it is like this means the sum of these two interior angles is 180. How much it is? 180 degrees. Therefore, A plus B is equals to 180. But A is nothing but what? 2 times of OAB and angle B means 2 times of OBC is equals to 180. If you take 2 as common, OAB plus OBC is equals to 90 degrees. That means what? Angle A plus angle B equal to 90 degrees. If you take, consider the triangle OAB, O plus A plus B equal to 180, but A plus B is equals to 90, therefore angle O is equals to 90. Okay na? Now we see the proof. If P A C O A P is equals to A C, therefore angle P A O is equals to angle C A O. Similarly, angle yes O P Q is equals to angle O B C. This is 1 and this is 2. Since you can write, since XY is parallel to X dash Y dash, therefore angle A plus angle B will be equal to 180. You can write because interior angles. Therefore, angle A can be written as 2 times of OAB, 2 times of OBA is equals to 180. Now, if you take 2 times, what happened? OAB plus OBA equal to 180. Therefore, OAB plus OBA is equals to 180 by 2 equal to 90 degrees. Yes. In triangle, AOB triangle AOB plus triangle ABO plus triangle BAO is equals to 180 degrees because it is a triangle. But AOB as it is, this plus this is nothing but 90 degrees is equals to 180. Therefore, angle AOB is equals to 180 minus 90 is equals to 90 degrees. So, very very important problem. This is 3-star important. Yes, one more important problem, same only, but now it is a triangle. Very simple. Now let it be x, let it be x, because these two are tangents. Now first use, one by one we use. This is nothing but center, and here have given height as 4 cm. All heights are 4. All lines are 4 cm. Now we know all sides, therefore we can use Heron's formula. Heron's formula was P equal to x plus 8 plus 8 plus 6 plus x plus 6. It is equal to 2x plus 8 plus 14 plus 6. Therefore, 2x plus 28, or if you take 2x, x plus 14. Therefore, semi-perimeter S is equals to P by 2 is equals to 2 into x plus 14 divided by 2. Therefore, 2 to cancel, it is x plus 4. Now, according to Heron's formula, area is equals to S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C square root. Then what happens? S is x plus 14. X plus 14 into x plus 14 minus of x plus 8. Again, x plus 14 minus 14, x plus 14 minus x plus 8 square root is equals to x plus 14 into x plus 14 minus x minus 8. X plus 14, 14 cancel, only x. Here x plus 14 minus x minus 8. Again square root is equals to x plus 14 into xx cancel. 14 minus 8 is 6 into x into minus x. 14 it means here 14x minus 8, here 14 minus 6, sorry, 6, it is nothing but 8. Therefore 48x into x plus 14, this is the 1. But here one by one we have to find out area. First area of AOB. Area of AOB half into AB into height. It is nothing but half into x plus 8 into 4. 2 1 2 2 2. So 2x plus 16. Next, like that only. Area of BOC is equals to half into 14 into 4. 2 1 2 2 2. 28 centimeter square. Third one, area of AOC is equals to half into x plus 6 into 4, 2 1 2 2 2, 2x plus 12 centimeter square. This is third, this is second, and this is first. Adding 1, 2, 3, adding 1, 2 and 3, what will get? 2x plus 16 plus 28 plus 2x plus 12. So 4x plus 56 is equals to 4, you could take x plus 14. Okay, now? This is 2, I have taken 2, 3, 4. 2, 3, 4, this is 5. But both are areas only, therefore equating 1 equal to 5. Therefore 48x into x plus 14 square root equal to 4 into x plus 14. Now squaring on both sides, what do you get? 48x into x plus 14 is equals to 4 square into x plus 14 into x plus 14. So x plus 14, x plus 14 cancel. 4 square is 16, 16 3 is then 4. So 3x is equals to x plus 14. 3x is equals to 3x minus x equal to 14. 2x equal to 14, which implies x equal to 7. Therefore, the sides are x plus 6, that is 7 plus 6 equal to 13. X plus 8 equal to 7 plus 8 equal to 15 centimeters. Thanks. Yes, today's last problem. You see one more. If it is a circle, it is a quadrilateral. Circumscribed by the circle, then we have to prove that the line segment A, B, C, D, P, Q, R, S. Then we have to prove that the line segment subtend the angle at the center is supplementary. That means what angle? AOB is equals to plus angle BOC is equals to 180 we have to show. Very, very simple. Okay, na? Right. Now, previously we have done one problem. Right? There, what happened? Here, 1. These two angles are same or not? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, you write that. Angle, yes, if it is O, O R plus R O Q plus Q O P plus P O S is equals to 360. 60 degrees. That means what? SOR means angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7 plus 8 is equals to 360 degrees. But angle 1 equal to angle 2, angle 3 equal to angle 4, angle 5 equal to angle 6, angle 7 equal to angle 8. Therefore, 2 times of angle 1 plus 2 times of angle 4 plus 2 times of angle 5 2 times of angle 8 is equals to 360. 2 if you take common, angle 1 plus angle 8, angle 4 plus angle 5 is equals to 360. Therefore, 1 plus 8 means AOB plus this is BOC is equals to 360 divided by 2 equal to 180 degrees.